Plastic debris is scattered across every corner of the world. Since the 1950s, the global economy has produced more than 9.2 billion tons of plastic, and 91% of that has never been recycled. This is a very complex issue. There is the heightened cost of sustainable materials, consumer hesitancy to pay more, and poor recycling infrastructure. It's a big list, and it's not just up to consumer brands and packaging suppliers to fix it. One of the biggest obstacles in producing sustainable packaging is the lack of materials that can be leveraged at scale. But now, materials suppliers are changing the game with sustainable resins that are cost competitive at high volumes. To learn more, we traveled to two materials suppliers who are driving the circular economy forward.
I'm Stephanie Baker. I'm the Director of Market Development for KW Plastics. We are the world's largest plastics recycler located in Troy, Alabama. We recycle, reprocess high-density polyethylene as well as post-consumer polypropylene right here at our facility. I would venture to say as much as 90% of our raw material comes from packaging, primarily bottles that are found in the kitchen, in the bathroom, even out in the garage. We purchase bales of this material from throughout North America and even beyond our borders. And that is size reduced, it's washed, and our end product is a post-consumer resin that is then sold back into many applications, the majority which is actually packaging. We are actually seeing a lot of innovation incorporating post-consumer resin in packaging beyond the bottle. The first that comes to mind is caps and closures. We're seeing a lot of popularity with our polypropylene in that application. Also tubs, tubes, disposable type of items such as the takeout trays, the deli platters, things like that. Really, our largest challenges in industry right now is gathering the raw material to be able to supply the demand, which is exciting that brands understand the value of post-consumer resin, but it's also a challenge in these are the same brands in many instances that are putting packaging on the shelves, that consumers are purchasing and putting in homes, and we need help to be able to pull these materials through the recycling bin so that we can, in fact, continue to supply the brands and meet the demand for post-consumer resin. We have moved beyond the education and outreach of recycling. I think people generally understand that recycling is a good thing, but they don't always understand where they can go to recycle, what they can put in the bin. And I think we don't talk enough about the value of recycled materials. It truly is a commodity. We are paying for this material and we can't get enough of it. For every package that goes to a landfill, there's a price tag that is associated with that if it is a package that can be recycled. The more that we can do to really let people know that there's value in their packaging, there's value when they make that split second choice whether to put it into a recycling bin or a trash bin, and there's value all along the supply chain in terms of jobs and revenue. And I think that is a large challenge that we have as an industry, is really connecting that economic message to the package.
So post-consumer recycled resin isn't the only way for brands to increase the sustainability profile of their packaging. Compostable or biodegradable materials are also a huge part of this conversation, but even they need to be disposed of properly. There are several agencies that will certify your finished product or resin for compostability or biodegradation. The different standards you can achieve include industrial composting, home composting, soil degradation, fresh water, and ultimately marine water. As you move up these categories, it becomes more difficult for packaging to decompose naturally due to the lack of bacteria. If biodegradable plastic is disposed of in an oxygen-rich environment, such as composting, it will break down into biomass, carbon dioxide, and water. But if it's disposed of in an environment that lacks oxygen, it will dissolve into a greenhouse gas like methane. Where the plastic devolves heavily influences the type of impact it will have on the environment, or so was the case until PHA. Located in Bainbridge, Georgia, Danimer Scientific offers access to the world's first marine water certified bioresin.
I was attracted to the industry really because I'm an outdoorsman, and it really bothers me when I see plastic floating down the river and those kind of things. I have a real passion, I guess, against litter and pollution, and I saw it as an opportunity to make a difference, to help. At Danimer, we make bio-based plastics out of renewable materials that will either compost or biodegrade. The biggest material breakthrough in packaging today is our PHA polymer. This polymer is marine biodegradable, where the incumbents are all industrially compostable. So we're making a huge multi-step change all at once here in terms of capabilities. That's the real trick, is you can have a resin that is renewable and biodegradable or compostable, but you gotta make it work. It has to work in the application. And that's really what we're focusing on now, is kind of moving the industry from industrially compostable solutions to home compostable solutions and marine biodegradable solutions. The production process for PHA is really unique. We start with soil bacteria, and we feed it vegetable oil, and it goes through the fermentation process. It fattens up and it multiplies. And once the vessel is full, we end the process and we extract the stored energy reserve from the bacteria. So if you think about these soil bacteria, when they start eating, they get full, but there's still food there, so they keep eating, kind of like us, and they get fat. And so we take the bug fat out and we clean it up, and that is the plastic resin, and that's what makes it such a great solution, because it's a preferred food source for bacteria. So one of the challenges that we work with are helping our customers with are getting these products to perform at the same rate, so that it's not a big economic hit to the customer to run these products. So as an example, you know, a lot of people are trying to do away with fossil fuel-based straws. So a marine biodegradable straw resin on the same machine at the same speed, then it's more economically viable.
As new materials technologies are commercialized, they offer new opportunities to consumer packaged goods companies. Jabil Packaging Solutions collaborates with some of the world's largest brands to improve and expand their packaging portfolio.
In the world of business, we've constantly pursued the best performing solution at the lowest price. And that has resulted in the current designs of packaging that we have. And I would say that we've done a good job over the years in terms of lightweighting and reducing costs relative to reduced material consumptions. And those elements yield a sustainability benefit. But sustainability in terms of end of life hasn't been as much of a focus as it should be. So as we look at end of life, meaning recapturing, reusing, recycling, or biodegradation or composting, that's the piece of the puzzle regarding sustainability that we haven't put enough effort into. Solutions are out there, technology has been developed, and it's continuing to be developed and advanced, but it's not to a level of maturity where it meets the requirements of the incumbent solutions. But I believe we're at an inflection point now where we're willing to make the hard decisions and tolerate a different cost or different performance in order to yield a better end-of-life sustainable solution.
I can say that we are being asked almost every day for a solution to a sustainable packaging goal or objective, and that today it's probably more intense and more frequent than any time in recent memory. A lot of times when people think about sustainable packaging, they think about plastics and they think about ocean plastics and things like that. Well, there are many other aspects associated with sustainability. For example, the carbon emissions that are released by the manufacturer of the packaging, the production of the product, the shipping of the product from point A to point B, the warehousing, etc. They could also think of things as making a packaging reusable, so it could be used once and then recycled and reused in the same application. So you have to understand and assess that package for its end of life, its impact to the environment through carbon emissions, and then you have to be able to design it using all of that in mind. So the material science and the package development itself is the key.
The maturation of materials technology is a critical part of the sustainable packaging story. And compostable and post-consumer recycled polymers are already playing a big role in turning the tide. Every day, packaging converters are working with customers to reduce their carbon footprint, lightweight products, and design for recyclability. But more and more, we're also seeing these sustainable materials move into high-volume projects where they can really make a difference. It's clear that we need more investment, more buy-in, and more energy across the entire value chain. But the progress and the innovation are unmistakable.
So this is going to require collaboration across the entire supply chain, starting with materials, converters, our customers, consumers, and then end-of-life providers such as waste management, material recovery facilities, or composting facilities.
PHA is a very significant polymer for the world and in terms of this fight against plastic waste. You know, eventually, we hope to replace as much of the stuff that's not finding its way into recycling as possible so that in the future, we don't clog the waterways and the ocean up with plastic.
This is probably one of the most changing environments that I've ever seen, including things like tamper evidence and child-resistant packaging and things like that. The need for sustainable packaging is quite significant. Everyone is looking for some kind of new technology, a new technique to run their package.
I think a big misconception that is a challenge for recycling is people don't understand the value of recycling. The reality is that recycling is not just an environmental issue, it's an economic one as well.
The sustainability movement doesn't start or end with any one person or organization. Protecting the beauty and resources of our Earth is larger than any individual effort. It's a worldwide revolution.